me. So today I'm going to do a Q&A video, and here are the questions that I got. One, what TV shows do you like to watch as a kid? Well, honestly speaking, as a young child, I didn't like watching kids shows, you know, that were for my age to watch, like Sesame Street, Teletubbies, Dora the Explorer, and you know, there's just some other kids shows I was not fond of at all, and I did not like watching kids. Me, I just felt like, why am I watching this? So, yeah, that's all I gotta say is that I didn't like watching those shows. And I also didn't watch any Nickelodeon shows as a kid, because I don't think I had that channel. You know, like at the time, the kind of cable that I had at the time did not have that channel, the Nickelodeon channel. But I mean, I know there are some people who probably grew up watching Nickelodeon shows, but I didn't. But that's okay though. So yeah, I didn't like watching Sesame Street, what else? Teletubbies, Dora the Explorer. I did not like those at all, because to me it felt like, well, why am I watching this? Like, to me it made no sense why it would be on the TV for me to watch, because when I would see any of those shows on the TV, I'm like, I don't like it. But the shows I did like watching were not kids shows for my age to watch. These shows were more like mature, you know, for adults to watch. Now, some of them aren't like that. And the shows I liked watching as a kid was The First Prince of Bel-Air, Everybody Loves Raymond, Just Shoot Me. Oh man, I feel like I'm forgetting some other shows. Roswell, even though I had 3 seasons, I still like watching Roswell. Third Rock from the Sun, I love that show, and I even loved watching as a kid because, you know, I just loved how it was just so funny, you know, especially, you know, with actors, how they portrayed these characters as, you know, aliens, but they, it's like they look human, but yet they have, they're on Earth to experience, human life, and how humans interact with each other, and to, it's like they learn something new in each episode, like what they're feeling, and they come to understand why humans feel the way they do depending when something happens, depending on the situation, and depending just mainly what's going on, whether if it's someone that's causing the problem or something else. So it's like they learn something new of that, and I think even the way they react to certain things is just really funny, and yeah, I just love that show. So those are the shows I love watching as a kid, because me, I find those shows more, yes, they were mature, and yes, I think there were some episodes that did have some mature adult jokes in there, which, of course, I didn't quite understand what they were saying, but yet, I just found it funny, even when they react to certain things in a certain way. So yeah, I love popping out girls, and I still do. And so yeah, those are the clothes I actually liked watching as a kid, because to me, I felt like I wanted to watch TV shows where it didn't make me feel like I'm this, you know, small baby who's barely starting to learn things. So yeah, I think watching those shows just made me felt like that even I was learning something from it, even a little bit, and even just mostly being entertained and laughing, like, oh wow, it's so funny. So yeah, those are shows that I like watching. And here are the questions my new friend Martin asked me. So Martin, if you're watching this, I'm going to be answering your questions that you sent to me. 2, do you think comic book movies are getting stale? Well, I can see why you asked that. No, I don't think so. I mean, I don't think comic book movies are getting stale. But here's what I think. It's not really the movie itself that's the issue of the comic book movies themselves. I think what makes some comic book movies doesn't seem that enjoyable or doesn't seem to really fit a certain a storyline for the movie and for the superhero themselves. I think there are just some comic book movies that just doesn't seem to go that well, like some of us hoped it would be. It's not really the movie itself. I think it's mostly because it's like the writers, and I think it's them thinking how they want to do it, like how they want to write this movie and how they want to put it together. So I think when it comes down to that, like writing the story and directing it in a way where they probably think it looks good, but in the end it just doesn't. So I think that's what it is, that somehow there are some writers that can't really think of any new fresh ideas and stories to make the comic book movies more entertaining, more enjoyable, and where some of us can relate to the characters and be like, wow, that was a good superhero movie. So I think it's just that. I think it's just somehow maybe there's some writers and directors who can't really think of any new and fresh ideas for the story for any comic book movies. Now, there are some comic book movies I do consider really good. And of course, there are some that did not turn out good. So that's what I think. And another question he asked me, what was the first movie you saw in the cinema? Okay, that's a good question, but I'm not sure if this really counts or not, but to me in a way it does. But the first movie I saw, which I don't remember watching, was Jurassic Park. And I say that of me not remembering seeing it, because when Jurassic Park came out, June 11th, 1993, I was a year old. Yes, because I was born in 1991, so in June, at least, because my birthday's in November, so at least before my birthday in 1993, I was still a year old. So even my mom told me the story. She said that her and my dad took me, and I think with my sister, that they took me to go see Jurassic Park, you know, because we all went. And considering that I was still a baby, you know, a year old, about to be two in November that year, she said that when the T-Rex came that I was so scared, that I was crying and screaming, and, you know, of course my mom felt bad, like, oh no, she's scared watching this, and, but that's something I don't remember. Because, of course, being a year old at the time Jurassic Park came out, I don't remember that. I don't remember being a year old and going to the theater with my mom, dad, and sister, and just, like, crying and screaming and being scared of the T-Rex in a movie. I don't remember that. You know, of course, I was too young, like, I was so young that I can't really remember. You know, because, of course, I still can remember being a year old. I mean, maybe some people do, but I don't. To be honest, I'm glad that didn't make sense. I'm just glad I don't remember being a year old and just crying and screaming when seeing Jurassic Park in theaters, just because as I got a bit older, I have to say, I don't know, maybe around 5 or there, I think from 5 and up, that the more I watched Jurassic Park, I loved it. Like, here's the thing, the only thing I remember is that watching Jurassic Park at home, and I would always enjoy it, and just even feeling like, wow, like, I would feel amazed and blown away by seeing the T-Rex. And I remember at some point when I got older, when my mom told me, like, oh yeah, when you're a baby and we took you to see Jurassic Park, you were crying and screaming. I'm like, what? Like, okay, well, I can understand why I was crying and screaming because I was a baby, but I don't remember that. Like, I think, yeah, from being a baby to maybe 2, 3, 4, yeah, I don't remember being scared of the T-Rex at all. The only thing I do know, that I do remember, is that I love the T-Rex, and I was just so fascinated by it, which I still am. So that was the first movie I saw in theaters, was Jurassic Park, and I was a year old. So yeah, that's like my first time. And yeah, ever since then, I saw other movies in theaters, you know, as a kid, as a teenager, and as an adult. And not so long ago, on Wednesday, me and my sisters and Mason nephew, we all saw the movie Rampage, so that was really good. And yeah, I enjoyed watching it, and believe me, it was so intense that there were certain parts where I couldn't believe what was going on, and I'm like, oh my gosh, like, I had no words to what was going on, especially when it came to the fighting, like, those animals fighting, like, the crocodile, the wolf, and then the gorilla. I'm like, oh gosh. But I still like it, though. Last question. What's your favorite animated movie and why? Well, now the thing is, I don't have one, like, I don't have just one favorite animated movie. I have, like, I have a lot, but not, like, a lot. Some of my favorite animated movies are most of them are Disney movies, like, Sleeping Beauty, Brother Bear, what else? Zootopia, The Lion King. Now, of course, The Lion King is, like, my number one favorite Disney movie. But there's another favorite animated movie that's my favorite that's not Disney, and that's Spirit, Stallion of the Cimarron. And if you don't know what Spirit, Stallion of the Cimarron is, I highly recommend it. It's such a good movie, and it's a movie about a horse. And so, like I said, I have like many favorite animated movies, but one of them is also Spirit. It's a DreamWorks animated movie, and I really love that one because, yeah, that is like, I have to say that's like my only favorite DreamWorks animated movie is Spirit, Stallion of the Cimarron. And the reason why Spirit is the only favorite DreamWorks animated movie that's my favorite because, like, it really stood out to me. You know, it did. Like, I just love everything about it, the story, the characters, and how it was put together with the animation and the story. I think I already said that. And the cast. And everything about it just made it so great. And it's such a really great, wonderful movie. And that's like my only favorite DreamWorks animated movie ever. And not just only how great it is and how it's such a great movie with so many great things in it, and it's such a wonderful movie. Like, it's moving, and I love it because I can really relate to it. I can really relate to the movie personally, in my life, and I can personally relate to the character Spirit himself, Spirit the horse, but I can really relate to him, because, okay, I'm trying to think, because I feel like with Spirit, I feel like, yeah, I can really relate to Spirit because I just feel like that, well, I don't know how else to describe it, but it's just one of those things where the character Spirit is so relatable that I can really personally relate to Spirit because, he's brave and he does things on his own. Like, he's an independent horse, but yet he finds his way back home to his family, and I feel like that's me. I feel like with Spirit's personality and the things he does, I feel like that's me. I feel like, me and Spirit have the same personality. Like, we get mad when we need to. Like, if someone makes us mad, it's like we would have the right to be mad, and no one can say, oh, don't be mad, or don't think like that, or you shouldn't say that. Because Spirit, I think Spirit is a very, like, he really expresses himself, especially how he feels, and like, in a way, he's not ashamed to express those feelings, and that's how I feel. I feel like no matter what I'm feeling, I get to express what I feel, and yet, same thing, is like, it's kind of like, in other words, he's not sorry for expressing those feelings, and yet I'm not sorry for expressing the feelings I feel, no matter what it may be. So it's like, in other words, it's like this fear is like, I'm not sorry for being me, for being the way that I am. And that's how I feel too. That's why I can personally connect the Spirit here, because I feel like, you know what? I'm not sorry for being me and to express what I feel and to express what I need to say because this is how I feel. So I finally realized I am not sorry for being me. Because it's like, look, this is me, and if I'm going to say this, let me say it. Don't tell me I shouldn't, because I'm going to say it anyway. And if I feel something, don't tell me I shouldn't, because come on. So that's pretty much all the questions for today. And I'm sorry this video is a little bit long than I thought it would be, but that's okay. So I hope you enjoy this Q&A video, and I'll see you at the movie. And I'm sorry if my camera somehow is changing colors back and forth. I don't know why it's doing that. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this Q&A video, and subscribe to this channel, and if you like this video, give it a like. And the next time, if I have a Q&A video coming up, which is each month, so if you have any questions, feel free to ask me in a comment. So that's all for today, and I'll see you at the movies.